through my experience of learning French, I've met two kinds of people. I think you can already see where I'm going with this. The kinds that help and the kinds that don't help. The positive and the negative kind that is. But just looking back at my journey and reflecting on it, I realize it's a little more complex than that. And it's not as simple as positive and negative. I've already spoken about one kind of people that you will meet when you're learning French.
Well, moving to France and trying to learn French, I think you should be careful of this trap where the local, and they mean you well, but the locals say that you're doing such a good job when you're probably not.
Today I want to talk to you guys about the diametrically opposite kind. This is going to involve a proper story time, so grab a popcorn and let's settle in. Language learning, unlike math and science, it's a very social skill. You learn it from your parents, from your friends. You need people to learn it. Back when I was in Lille in business school, I used to co-organize this language learning club every Thursday. And this helped me with my listening because it was a crowded, noisy place. And it also helped me with my speech because it was a crowded, noisy place. And I had to make myself heard and understood in French. So there was this Indian dude who spoke flawless French, and I had the pleasure, displeasure, more displeasure than pleasure, because he just kept draining my energy out. He would make inappropriate jokes. Many of them were sexual, and I was just not in the mood to get into he'd laugh out loud. And his French was really good, not to say the least about his French, but I think he also kept mocking me and my level of French, my pronunciation. And although I thought I was understandable, he just kept pretending to not understand what I was saying. And it just crushed my self-esteem, because I thought I was doing okay. Of course, I was not fluent, but I thought I was doing okay. So for me, when I realized that this is going to borderline bullying, I just left the table and I've met other people on another table, because that's the benefit of these language learning clubs. Towards the end of the evening, I asked him how did his French get so good. And I was surprised that he was so willing to help. He asked if he could add me on Instagram. I said, all right, let's do this. He did, and he gave me a list of things that worked for him. We have the same background. He's from South India too. So he gave me a list of material that worked for him and a list of exercises and the methods that he followed that helped him crack French to such a high level. He even ended up saying that my French was not that bad after all. And I didn't know which one to believe now, the one where he was making fun of me or the one where he says that I'm doing okay. But I do think I judged him too quick. If he was really trying to be mean, then why would he help me, right? I don't think bullying is okay. If someone does that to you, I don't think you should try to make peace or try to understand why they're doing it. They are the problem, not you. I'm just trying to say that out. But when it comes to the negative kind of influence in your life, I just want to differentiate it way further, because not all what seems negative is negative. So the reason I perceived this as negative is because I didn't like the kind of jokes. For him, it was obviously normal. I didn't like the kind of relating with me, because for him, that was obviously normal. And for me, not. We're just not supposed to be friends, I guess. But before writing someone off entirely, I think it's important to express oneself and to be a little brave and say what you feel like. And there are people who don't have the energy or patience to listen to you. To those people, I just say let them go and make friends who really want to help you in your life. I was completely wrong about this person just because I didn't get his humor, and it was not my kind of humor. And that'll happen over and over again, and I would feel lonely and unsociable. Impossible for me to make friends in a foreign land, and I would always go back to the excuse of if I was back in India, I would do better. But I'm not in India. I'm now in France, and I should try to make friends over here, right? Work with what we have. But just hanging out with him over the next couple of Thursdays over the language learning club, I realized that this person is really willing to help me. He proposed to help me with job applications and so on. And the kind of thing that I'm getting at over here is, if you want to put yourself in front of strangers constantly, then you should grow a thick skin, because people are not going to be the way your parents treated you. People are not going to treat you the way your nostalgic friends who you've known for 12 years are going to treat you. Some people are going to challenge you in the right way and some in the wrong way. At least I needed to learn to stand up for myself and tell what part of it I did not appreciate. It's really easy to write someone off, and in that case, I think we'll never learn, because there are benefits to these kind of people who challenge you in a negative way. When I say negative, I mean someone who makes you feel bad, and that's not necessarily a bad thing. The positive, unreliable type of feedback that people give you, this is really bad, because you don't even know that you need to improve. And with the salvageable kind, if you're socially smart enough, you show your vulnerability. I think what I said was, I need help with learning French. I'm not that good. And how did you get that good? That just disarms some. If you kept defending yourself, saying that, no, my French is good enough, it disarms completely someone when you accept that you need to improve. And then the whole tone of the conversation changes. And he was like, no, of course, you're already doing really well. I think you could look into these kind of resources. That's where you seem to struggle. And I think if you polished these two things up, you're golden, you know. The really tricky part about this whole exercise is discerning what's negative salvageable and what's negative inaccurate, dead inaccurate. But because people have come up to me and said really mean things about my life, and you at one point you really need to grow a thick skin and say, this is not for me, this person is just inaccurate, this person is just wrong, has to work on something in his own life, and what he said is just dead untrue. However, on the positive side, they're really good kinds, they're constructive people, make you feel really good, may not challenge and push you that hard. Because another benefit of this salvageable kind is I felt challenged. I would go back to my bedroom and I would work on my pronunciation because someone called me out on that. And that's probably when I wrote this goal of mine to have proper French pronunciation, and it has brought me a long way. So it's another benefit of the negative encouragement kind, negative as in feel negative kind. They are accurate. They don't feel good, but they are accurate. They are salvageable and they are accurate. You will need the partnership of good friends. And I remember after speaking about this, I did ask my friend. Actually, let's just call that friend of mine.
Salut Florian, comment ça va?
Ça va bien, merci. Et toi?
Ça va aussi. Je suis en train de t'enregistrer. Je me souviens quand on s'est vu à Paris il y a 2 ans. Je t'avais demandé par rapport à ma prononciation quand je parle français. Tu te souviens ce que tu avais dit? Tu peux répéter s'il te plaît?
Je me souviens, oui, en fait, je trouve que t'as forcément un petit accent étranger, mais je trouve que t'as pas un accent spécialement indien très fort. Donc...
Je savais pas quel étranger, mais sûrement étranger, c'est ça?
Oui, parce que bon, ça se sent quand même que tu n'es pas français, mais tu sais, c'est pas. Après, je dirais, non, tu pourrais pas être belge, mais tu pourrais être, je sais pas, un autre pays, mais n'importe quel pays en fait, ouais. On n'arrive pas trop à identifier, c'est vrai, le pays.
Merci beaucoup, Florilène.
Voilà, de rien.
Bonne journée, salut!
For as long as the challenging, true kind of feedback is true, then you need to work on it. It's just so easy to be in your comfort zone and be in your bedroom watching French TV shows. And I think it does not work, the hearing and the speaking in a crowded place, those skills in real life, it doesn't work, those things. So I encourage you to step out of your comfort zone, go out and talk to people once this COVID thing is just entirely gone. But beware that there will be people who will drain the living life out of you. And it's important to take time to discern which part of it is true and which part of it is untrue. I hope that was helpful, guys. Making friends is a very effective way of learning French or any language that you're learning. But it's also important to find people who will challenge. Take care of yourselves and I'll see you in the next one. Peace. No, I don't say peace. I say keep learning. Keep learning and make friends. But keep learning.